thanks for having me here.
No, no, it's God wanted you to be here. You know how this happened. So how many of you know about him beyond his Pami auntie avatar? Do you know what he does for a living in real life, apart from being Pami auntie? Does anybody know? So he runs his pharmaceuticals business, which his father started. It's a business of raw materials for pharmaceuticals. He's an entrepreneur now. He's a production company. He's an entertainer. He's an entrepreneur. Sumer, you've done everything. Is there something left to be done? You're popular, famous. You make people smile. Is there something left? Is there a bucket list you have in 2020?
Yes. I think so. Bucket list helps me going on in my life. I still have to swap the roles maybe one day. Sumira, Pammi, auntie, interviewing you at this prestigious platform maybe.
Typical Punjabi from Delhi.
Typical. Dusre ki bhi roti chheen lo.
Haan, bilkul, bilkul. Wo to main khata hi hun logon ka khana, dekho. Tabhi main aisa hun. So, but what is left to be done? I mean, genuinely, you achieve some a lot.
Well, there's always a scope to progress in life. As you just mentioned, I'm working on my own productions now. Hope to make it bigger. I want to come up with a nice talk show where I can possibly invite the best of all the streams. I'm not saying just the Bollywood, but maybe I would love to interview some of the greatest politicians we have now. Or probably a chef, maybe a dancer, maybe a comedian on different level and get into the insight of their life. That's how I wish.
Who would you want to be interviewed? Tell me top five guests on your show.
Mr. Rishi Kapoor, great fan, and it's his one tweet actually, which some people know or may not know, changed my life because that, when Mr. Rishi Kapoor tweeted about Pammi auntie, that's how the media attention came to me. So he has a big hand in my Pammi auntie success. Definitely him. I would actually love to interview Vikas Khanna, the chef, great admirer, being a Punjabi, of course. Another person I would love to interview in my list, if I may name the dead people, if I can. I would love to interview Mrs. Sushma Swaraj, for sure.
And what would you have asked her?
What would I have asked her? Well, going back then, when she was there, the kind of situation we were in, I would have asked her in a very Pammi auntie style, Desh da ki banega hun penji. But she was one of the best foreign minister we had. So I think so we could have connected a lot on issues over in India issues. I would love to interview, who else? Maybe singer like Diljit Dosanjh or something, who have made it from nowhere. I always say there are people who get famous, but there are people, half the people don't know their success story from where they come or from where they rise.
And their struggles.
Their struggles. I want to focus on their struggles rather than what they are now.
Yeah. In Delhi, there is a famous saying I use all the time. A lot of people in Delhi are famous for being famous. They actually achieve nothing. So, but that's another conversation.
Thanks to the social media.
Yes. You know, tell me top five things that have had influence on your life. You know, say, let's say five conversations you remember. There are five defining moments in your life. If you had to put them like that.
The five moments of my personal life would be, you know, when I stepped out of school, I had this thing, you know, when you're in school, you're one of the most famous students of the school. And sabko lagta hai ki ye insaan
modern school mein gaye the.
Modern school bara ka.
Dekhiye, mereko pehle research nahi ki aapne aise famous bola to main samajh gaya.
That's inherited. वो बचपन से ही modern school के होते सब कुछ अच्छा है.
मैं भी चाहता था कि मेरे बच्चे वहाँ जाएं, लेकिन मेरी बीवी जहाँ चाहती थी वो वहाँ जाते.
Fair enough. Well, at the end of the day, yeah. Once I stepped out of the school, you know, being the most famous kid or the most talented kid of the school, I thought the doors will be very easy. All the universities will be, or everybody will be like, "Hey, Sumi, please come in a university and blah blah." By the way, I didn't do Delhi University. Reason what happened? Not because my whole focus was curricular, not the exams. And that time, my dad, the best thing, he used to say like, "Insan achhe bano, numbero ka kuch zada hai nahi." Because, and that's why I think so. This whole board exam thing comes from the experience which I have learned in my life. You need to work hard to achieve where you.
Delhi mein koi parent hi nahi bolta.
कि अच्छा इंसान बनो या नंबर मत लाओ?
नंबर मत लाओ.
नंबर अच्छा इंसान से लिए बोलते हैं आजकल.
नहीं, उसके लिए बोलना नहीं पड़ता, करना पड़ता है. बोलने वाले तो शायद होंगे. बट यू नो somebody was asking me, there's a PR agency owner, she was in our list and she has a 3-year-old daughter and she was asking me about school. And I told her, this is, are you happy with your kid's school? I said, there's no parent in Delhi who's happy with any school their kids go to. So, you know.
But very frankly, the kids are not happy with any school nowadays. It's the parents and the social status has so much with the thing, hamara bachcha kaun se school mein ja raha, instead of actually thinking about what the kids are going through.
So my kids are very happy with the school they go to. And, you know, I like to believe they're well-rounded. But home is a school. So my wife deserves the credit. But that's another topic. So five top. One is, your father told you that it's better to be a better human being than go after marks.
Yes, don't go after marks. And later I realized that, you know, I was very a small fish in that big ocean created by myself that I'm the best, of course. Later I got to know there is a lot outside the world. Second communication was my dad, rather the miscommunication, because me and my dad never actually were on the same line when it comes to business, I think. So that's another conversation. When he actually said, ठीक है, जब तुम बिजनेस छोड़ोगे या तुम घर से बाहर निकलोगे तो तुम्हें पता चलेगा कि तुम किस लायक हो. सो दैट इज वन ऑफ द कॉन्वर्सेशन आई ऑलवेज रिमेंबर. एंड अनदर विद कनेक्ट टू दिस सेम इंफॉर्मेशन कॉन्वर्सेशन, आई थिंक सो इन 96 व्हेन आई वाज इन लॉस एंजेलिस, आई वांटेड टू बाय वन कलोन, आई डोंट रिमेंबर द नेम. एंड माय कजिन देयर अननोइंगली दैट दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन माइट चेंज माय लाइफ और माइट अफेक्ट मी सो मच, शी इज लाइक, व्हाई यू बाइंग दिस cologne? I'm like, because I like it. She's like, it's for $104 in 96. I'm like, so what? I have money. She's like, did you earn it? I don't know why it just hit me so hard. And I'm like, I have to make my own identity. And from there, the whole game changed in my life. Yeah.
And Sumer, you didn't listen to your father's voice initially. You left India, yep. Well, started in Australia. Then you made the choice to come back. Your father is in heaven now.
Yep.
And Pami Hanti happened in 2015.
2016.
And that changed your life. Now, we are at a communication conference, and the title of the session was Comedy, Communication and Change. Do you think you're doing social messaging all the time and engineering a change through your communication, if you take your act to be communication?
Yes, I think so. When you come to a certain stage, whether you are doing comedy or you are on any platform, it is the duty, if you can get that change in the society from your, whether it's a comedy way or the serious way, not just the comedy. And comedy does play an important role in this stuff, because I guess we all are so tired nowadays just looking at the serious stuff on any of your social media. Jahan par bhi kuch serious koi lecture dene aata na, for me, it's like, oh yaar, mereko pata hai, pehle se hi pata hai. But the moment something comedy comes, you listen. You're like, oh yes, he said the right thing in a very light way and does make an effect. I think so, that's where I like getting into comedy, more sarcastic way or that way, yeah.
So, tell us some funny moments that have happened because of Pami Hanti. I know it got you to fame, it made you popular as a character, and you know, people know you now. But tell us some of the funny things that have happened because of Pami Aunty.
Kaash aap hamari saas hote. I actually get...
Bacche hai aapke?
Pami Aunty ke to do bacche hai, mere nahi hai.
Haan, matlab.
But yes, I do get messages on social media ke Sumir, I wish you were my saas. And I'm like, are you serious? They think Pami Aunty is a very funny and very nice lady, and it is funny to have lady like that, but let me just tell you, she's the most hypocrite lady and she's the most kapatti saas you can ever get it in your life. So never wish for Pami Aunty to be the saas like that, because Pami has been trained by her saas, and what Pami now does, she has been the victim of that. That's how Pami is now.
So how much of it is growing up in Delhi and seeing people around you, and how much is it research, the Pami Aunty that comes on the screen?
What Pami Aunty you see on screen is from the observation I do around. For example, if I sit with you for a long time, maybe you will come up with some story of your house. I'll quietly listen. Ah, ye story thodi Pami Aunty ka masala ho sakta hai. Maybe from my past, maybe the way my dadi used to.
Because if Bombay mein rehte to Delhi wali Pami Aunty kaise Bombay mein aa jati hai?
Pami kahi bhi pahunch jati hai. But yes, I have an influence. a hardcore Punjabi, and I have an influence from Delhi a lot. I've been born in Delhi, and I've seen people like Pammi Aunty around me. My Nanka is from Amritsar, so when you hear Pammi Aunty, total Amritsari Aunty talking and nagging about small issues about life, yeah.
You know, you're a product of social media. We are in a communication conference. I keep reiterating that. And social media is very important in today's scenario, both for listening and for dissemination. But, I mean, it's like a double-edged sword. What is your view on social media? And a candid one at that.
I'm a byproduct of social media now. But very frankly, somewhat similar question was asked to me by BBC World. People came. And they say, what if social media is nowhere now? Or what if they start hiding the likes? They had this thing going on in other countries. I like it. That will be the best thing that can happen. You know, I always thought social media was a platform to showcase your talent or put your view across. But it has become such a big competition now.
It's become a show-off like Bambi.
Show-off. Plus, it has become a stress. If today I put a picture with Mr. Anurag Batra, my whole focus whole day will be kitne likes aaye.
Aayenge nahi.
Instead of, I'm quite sure I said that. But the whole thing of being in a competition ki kitne likes aaye, nahi aaye, I think so. That's what the new generation, some of them have become self-acclaimed bloggers who nobody cares about.
And they don't know anything about anything.
Exactly. So I think so. This whole thing has become overhyped. The best thing, social media has happened. Yes, you have a voice. You can put it across wherever. But people are using it very unprofessional way and not good way. Yes. And I am totally against that.
Now, as I started, you know, comedy, communication change, social messaging. If Pammi Aunty had to do some takes on some of the current issues, can you do a Pammi Aunty for us? Example, a take on same-sex, or cab, or Donald Trump, Boris Johnson.
I have talked about these things, but just for instance, I had this take about Handa Penji da Munda Gay Haga. So if I may just...
Kere Khanna Ji?
Handa Penji.
So there was this...
When Section 377 hata tha, so Handa Penji was very...
Upset
ke unka beta gay hai. So my duty from a social message or something, I did like, Hanji Handa Penji, ki haal chaal? Hai? Ki kende payo? Main tuhanu halle hi phone karni ha. So now Pammi calls Malhotra Penji because she loves to gossip. Malhotra Penji, gal suno Handa Penji te munde di kadmai tut gayi hai. Haan haan, Penji do din, shadi te do din pehle munda kende ho gay ho gaya. Penji, वैसे तो आनो की लगता है ना नो बड़ी देर बाद में पता चला पेंजी मैं तो 5 साल पहले ही समझ गई थी जब उन्हां दा मुंडा मेरे को लाया सी मेरी धी दी शादी ते कहंदा आंटी तुहाडा डायमंड दा सेट बहुत चंगा पेंजी मैं तो झट ही समझ गई थी कि मुंडा गे हैगा वैसे पेंजी बहुत ही चंगी गल आ गई आजकल ते कुछ नहीं होंदा इन्हां नु तो शुक्र मनाना चाहिदा दा एदा मुंडा गे हैगा कल नु इन्हां दी ना नू आएगी ना स्यापे पहनगे इन्हां दी ज्वेलरी इन्हां दे कोल ही रहेगी साडी जिंदगी बच जाएगी सो इन्हां funny way, I actually said that it's totally okay if your son is gay. It's totally Absolutely. Okay. Just embrace it. Love your child the way they are.
Yeah, I love, respect the difference. In my personal story, I have a friend, he's in heaven, he's American. He was American. I mean, he died 1.5 years back because of oral cancer. And he was gay. I went to his wedding in Istanbul. And I cried at the wedding and I realized, you know, they have the same feelings for their partner. Like we have, may have. So I'm more sensitive. And respect the differences. What do you have to say on cab? You were listening to the last panel.
Well, very frankly, if you ask Sumir, Sumir is still very confused with what is happening in the world. I actually posted on social media where people started trolling me for that, which is perfectly fine. That's part and parcel. Because a lot is being said from various sources and it is actually creating the confusion. But if you ask Pammi Aunty,
always.
She will have a very different take. She'll like, Penji, sare protest karde paine, lokanu aan nahi dena, ena nu aap nahi pata, adhi India te pehle illegal America che, te London che, je Europe te jaake baithi, shukar manayegi, jad ona nu othe status mil jaye, te je loki aake ena de kaar che baithe ne, te ena nu ki problem hagi hai.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Penji, adha Punjab te pehle hi America che illegal baithe hai, tusi ki galla karde pe ho.
कनाडा में
सो अपने लोग जब कहा इलीगल जाकर बैठ जाए परफेक्टली फाइन यहां पर बल्कि खुशियां मनाते की होया ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੱਲੇ 10 ਸਾਲ ਹੀ ਹੋਏ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਪਏ ਨੇ ਕਦੀ ਨਾ ਕਦੀ ਜਦ ਇਲੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਹੋਣਗੇ ਨਾ ਉਹ ਸ਼ਾਇਦ ਸਾਰੇ ਇਲੀਗਲ ਵਾਲਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਨਾ ਕਰਹਾਏ ਮੈਂ ਕਹਿੰਦੀ ਮਾਤਾ ਰਾਣੀ ਤੇਰਾ ਫਟਾਫਟ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਦੇ ਸੋ ਮੈਨੀ ਪੀਪਲ ਆਰ ਦੇਅਰ ਇਨ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਕੰਟਰੀਜ਼ ਬਟ ਇਟਸ ਓਕੇ ਵੈਨ ਯੋਰ ਓਨ ਪੀਪਲ ਆਰ ਦੇਅਰ ਇਨ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਕੰਟਰੀਜ਼ ਸਿਟਿੰਗ ਇਲੀਗਲ ਸਿਟਿੰਗ ਔਨ ਦੇ ਟੈਕਸ ਮਨੀ ਬਟ ਵੈਨ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਹੈਪਨਿੰਗ ਇਨ ਯੋਰ ਕੰਟਰੀ ਐਂਡ ਵੈਨ ਦ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਵਾਂਟਸ ਦੈਮ ਟੂ ਗੋ ਔਰ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਲਾਈਕ ਇਟਸ ਨਹੀਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਐਸਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਏ ਸੋ ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਸੋ Pammi has her own take and I am still very confused.
And my last, what would Pammi auntie say on Donald Trump?
Donald Trump and Pammi ki jo beti hai, uski saas mein aur Donald Trump mein koi farak nahi hai.
Kya baat hai? So why can't you enact that for us?
Well, okay. Hi sweetie, mummy bol rahi hu ki haal chaal. Hai, phir teri saas ladti pahi hai. ਇੱਕ ਤੇਰੀ ਸੱਸ ਦਾ ਤੇ ਡੋਨਲਡ ਟਰੰਪ ਦਾ ਸਿਆਪਿਆ ਨਾ ਨਾ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਪਸੰਦ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਨਾ ਤੇਰੀ ਸੱਸ ਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਪਸੰਦ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਮੈਂ ਕਹਿੰਦੀ ਹਾਂ ਦੋਨੋਂ ਭੈਣ ਭਰਾ ਨੂੰ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਹੌਲੂ ਲੂਲੂ ਕਿਉਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਭੇਜਦੇ ਤੇ ਵਿਪਾਸਨਾ ਯੋਗਾ ਕਰਨ ਸਭ ਤੁਮ ਕੱਢਣ 'ਚ ਬਾਹਰ ਲੱਗੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ
ਨਾਈਸ ਔਰ ਦੋਜ਼ ਆਫ ਯੂ ਡੋਨਟ ਨੋ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਪਲੀਜ਼ ਗੈਟ ਅ ਕ੍ਰੈਸ਼ ਕੋਰਸ ਐਂਡ ਵੀਲ ਕਾਲ ਹਿਮ ਨੈਕਸਟ ਈਅਰ ਬਟ ਮਾਈ ਲਾਸਟ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਵੀਲ ਗੈਟ ਦੀ ਆਡੀਅੰਸ ਟੂ ਕਮ ਇਨ ਕੀਪ ਟੂ ਆਰ ਟਾਈਮ ਇਫ ਦਿਸ ਵਨ ਮੈਸੇਜ ਦੈਟ ਯੂ ਊਡ ਸੇ ਟੂ the people running this country, what would that be? And if one message to all the citizens of the country and the people in this audience, what would that be?
Since it's a communication conference going on, I'll focus. When Mr. Gaurav was here, I think so the very right points were taken. Communication is very essential in today's time because lots of information is being misled. Lots of rumors are there. I think so the government, if they would have communicated certain things very clearly without confusing what might happen, what might not happen, the things would have been totally different. It's all about communication, and that's what I say. Today also, if Mr. Narendra Modi or anybody from the party, or they come on record and clear things, because there is a lot of misinformation going on, things will be much different, and I trust our whole country that people are there to listen. If there is something wrong, they will totally follow whatever is right for the country. They will.
I told you last, but I want to ask you, there's so much negativity, you know, strife. What is positive in the environment? Does Pammi auntie see any positivity in the environment?
Oh. Frankly, no.
Frankly, no.
I don't.
So that's a very candid and honest answer, because Pammi auntie is some reflection of his own beliefs, having grown up in...
When you have to think twice, when you have to keep... again, I'll still blame the social media. There are sometimes days when I don't open my Facebook, I'm at peace. Because the moment you open Facebook, there is a lot happening in the country. So, when you say ignorance is the bliss, this is the situation, right? Okay, but Delhi nahi karta ke jaano ke desh mein kya ho raha hai. When you want to be totally informed, you should know what is happening in the country, but at times it's like, you know what, apna kaam karo. If I'm a very simple middle class person, trust me, I just want to live my life at peace, get my basic right, get the best air possible, if India can provide it. 20 saal pehle life phir bhi bahut easy thi life India mein.
Wo to har generation ko lagta hai, but yes, life is complicated now, but it can be made simple. On this note, if there are questions in the audience, we can take the two questions. If there are no questions, I will ask one last question and wrap up. Any questions anybody has for Mr. Pasricha or Pammi auntie? No questions?
In school.
Okay. Yeah. The gentleman here, I don't know him.
Yes, sir. Please.
Tell us, give us your name and what do you do?
Hi, I'm Siddharth from Tadapar. I'm heading communication to Tadapar, Delhi. I have one question for you. Late we have seen... people from all walks of life, they enter into politics. What's your take on people from the entertainment, especially from the comedy side, to enter into politics? Because I believe that they can
fight. But your voice is not clear, because I don't
know. Are you asking him, will he enter politics?
I just want to know, you know.
So, would you want to be the next chief minister of Delhi?
Never.
Never.
I'm very happy as an entertainer. I think so.
No, Delhi chief minister is an entertainer too.
No, he is an entertainer.
With you on that.
He's at a different level entertainer. I'm a very happy space right now. But I don't think so. I'm capable enough. I'm very good at pointing what is wrong in the country, like we all have. But I think so when you actually get in that job, it is very difficult because there's lots of loopholes going on in the city and the country today. Kehna aasan hai ki main unki jagah hota. I'm not Anil Kapoor of the movie who took that oath and became the chief minister. But I will not enter politics, though I have been approached by lots of political parties to campaign for them. But I like to stay. Well, I'm very happy in my simple space.
Fantastic. Yes, sir. Rajiv. Mic to Rajiv Malik. Chetan.
Sir, my question to you is that when we have seen Pammi Aunty so fondly, but now seeing you with in this beard is a bit of a shock. So,
Pammi Aunty ki bhi beard hai, thi nahi.
No, but it is not that distinct, you know, as this. So, how do you like, you live in anonymity or you sometimes dress up like Pammi Aunty so that people recognize you?
I don't live in anonymity, I think. So, that was my very first focus from day one. When I started Pammi Aunty, that people should know the man behind Pammi Aunty.
Is there a neighbor, the man behind Pammi Aunty?
Yes, the man behind Pammi Aunty.
Okay,
so that was very from day one. And I only dress up as Pammi Aunty when I see there is something important to be said.
Do you think I can ever be Pammi Aunty?
Trust me, all men are Pammi Aunty. Everybody gossips in Delhi. Trust me, all men are Pammi Aunty. We just deny.
I'm very upset with you. I'm very upset with you.
In Punjabi,
we'll do a protest against you.
In Punjabi,
I'll organize a protest against you for calling all men.
It'd rather be a very peaceful protest. I will not stop you against the protest. You can. So, yes, sir, I only dress up as Pammi Aunty when I get a very hefty amount. If Mr. Anurag Patra would have said, Sumir, come up, dress up as Pammi, I would have loved to do that. Right. But he asked Sumir Pasricha to come.
Yes. So, any other questions? We can call it a day.
I have somebody
here. Last question to my friend there. Tell him what you do, and he runs an architecture firm.
Wow.
He lives in India. He's American.
Thank you. My name's Scott, and my question is about this comedy. In America, we have two programs: The Daily Report, The Daily Show, and a few other comedians tell the news. And one of the things I found is you hear more truth in the comedic news than you hear on the regular news. And you have the same thing here.
So he's saying we hear more truth on the comedy shows daily than we do on news TV. Is that what you're saying, Scott? Right?
Isn't it the best thing? Maybe the news channels are totally governed by the political parties, maybe, at times. They have fear that their channels might be banned. But as a comedian, I have nothing to lose, sir. I think so. We all need such people in life, in our country, to speak the truth. We had R.K. Lakshman in a long time. I always find him as my role model. If my small little voice can create a difference, well and good. Otherwise, I still say my heart in a very light way, as far as people are understanding.
And by the same corollary, I hope there is some comedy on news channel. I'm not referring to any news channel. Left to your imagination. But there is some comedy on news channel. Like there's some serious news and truth on comedy shows. I think the corollary is true for India in a reverse way, in a really sad way. But give Mr. Sumir Pasricha a big round of applause. Thank you for communicating the social message you do and entertaining us. God bless you.